Greetings, Earthlings. My name is Zero Jake, and welcome back to XCOM 2. We are heading to the Advent Retaliation that showed up at the worst possible time. I was just about to go on an alien base raid. We've got to rescue civilians as usual. With us, we've got two snipers, we've got a rookie, we've got a grenadier, and we've got whatever your name is, Chopper, I think it is. No, it's someone else. An Indriz or something. Because I need to have a look at your name. We're in the New Arctic as usual. It's very snowy and also very hot for some reason. I don't know why you're wearing aviators in the snow.
Minus 1-5, hostile forces are attacking the outpost. Eliminate all enemy units and protect those civilians.
Okay, we can do that. Aren't samurai, yes.
You won't have a concealed position for deployment on this one.
I understand, Central. We did just drop in a dropship. I don't know why we have a concealed position at all. Rhino, take that front position and see what you can see. Rhino have a smoke grenade here to be able to give cover to anyone who may be caught unawares. We've got a newcomer, Jack Roberts. We're going to move him up into low cover. We're going to move Greg up into this low cover here. This will allow both of them to be able to snipe at will and basically two-time everything. Then we've got Guseva, who is our current rookie in the situation. You're going to take the flank. Rhino, you're going to overwatch. And Samurai, you're going to... I don't know. There's nothing to do with your sword right now. I guess you can move here.
Roger that.
Excellent. How fun. Now, let's see who dies. Oh, okay. It's one of them, is it? We've got a berserker in that direction.
Casualties, Commander. We have to stop this.
Don't worry. I'll aggro him. Just give me a second for everyone else to kill people. Right, here we go. Here is the execution of plan get the innocents out of danger. We're going to throw in our rookie here.
Got it. Moving.
Because she's, you know, throwawayable. I completely forgot the word there. Right, we've got two mutons and a berserker. Very nice. I don't know if we can slash the berserker from here. No, we can't. Okay. Well, we can launch a grenade if we want to. We will only be able to hit the berserker, so that's kind of useless. We want to keep the high ground, and we want to kill the berserker as quickly as possible. Suppression. What do you do? Penalizes target's aim. That's not going to do much. Right, just shoot him. Shoot him with your inferior weapon. He's going to do some buff thing, as he usually does. Or not. And for some reason, the camera is shaking around. Bugs, ladies and gentlemen. Alternatively, you two do have access to shooting. This is making me nauseous. Please just stop it. Please just stop shaking the... Is this going to happen all the time? Until I kill him. Probably. Right, let's shoot this muton. We have no percent chance to crit hit. That's stupid. Right, let's just kill this berserker first. 100% chance to hit. We hit, obviously, because if we didn't, then that would be weird. Please, if this kills him, stop the shaky camera.
Enemy eliminated.
Oh, thank you. God. I thought I was going to be sick for a second. Right.
Finally.
Let's keep moving. Oh no. Oh no, no, no. He's the last person available. Right. Overwatch.
Covering now.
We've got people up in the north. Got a codex. Just headshot someone. I don't think we have a skulljack anymore. No, we don't have a skulljack anymore, so we're going to need to get one. To get that codex skulljacked. Because, of course, we lost five of our most powerful people. You, Overwatch, remove. He's moving up. He's going to do something such as shooting Samurai as well. You miss because you're such a bad shot.
Both.
And that's the end of that. Right. Rhino. Okay, Jack. Easy target. Easy. You should be able to do this without a cinch. You've got 65% chance to hit. Good. Good thing I was betting for you. Right. That did enough damage. We can grenade him if we want to. Rhino, I want you to get into heavy cover.
Move on, target location.
I want you to launch a frag grenade over here.
Take this.
Gets rid of the other muton's cover and kills the first one. There we go. Also gets rid of his armor so it's easier to kill him. We want samurai move here so that you can get the civilian out.
You're safe now. Go,
thank
go, go.
You. Thank God he wasn't, you know, faceless. We do have enemy reinforcements and faceless in this mission because reasons. Also known as I didn't stop a dark project. Move over here, see
confirmed.
If, you know, she's faceless. If she is, then oh my God,
out.
What the hell did I do? Good thing I'm not going to have to say that then. No person's getting executed. I can see it going right through their head. It's graphic.
We need to get these people out of here.
No, we're losing them up and up. God, can't you see, Central? Though I guess you are an NPC, after all. Right.
Let's move already.
Samurai, let's move. I want you to scout that very, very dangerous codex.
Moving.
Can't you see? Move here. How can you people not see the codex already?
Affirmative. Moving on.
She was literally right there. Right. I'm going to take a risk. I'm going to run and gun. Oh, God. Yes, this is a stupid risk. Oh, no. Oh, no. I'm hating this decision already. There we go. Shield bearer, stun lancer, and codex. Can I? Ooh, yes. You're on one health. You're going to clone, which means you simply teleport over there, which means you're flank. No, you're not flanking. That's good. Right, Rhino. We may have a problem. We may have a slight problem. You can't do anything. Right. I want a kill zone in this position.
On lockdown.
Thank you. And I want you to shoot the stun lancer. Actually, no, he's a heavy lancer now. Oh, that means he's even more bad-ish. Right, we're going to launch a smoke grenade in here so that it's harder for the enemy to kill the rookie. Hence why I brought the smoke grenade along. And it's also going to help that civilian as well. Increases the defense, which means it's harder to hit. Another civilian's dying. Oh God, that was quite brutal. Advent, Guardians of Peace. You know what peace actually means, right? It means death. Samurai is being flanked. You're going to actually shoot my... Oh, right. How could you see them, and how did you know they were overwatching? That's questionable. That's really questionable. This game really annoys me. Right. Stun lancers. How did you hit? We are in a like smoke cloud thing. And it also does mean that you're now in smoke as well. Right. First of all, let's kill this person. Let's kill this person safely. Don't even know if we can do it safely. Okay, so we have the option of trying to kill one of these people with samurai. Or what we can do is we can move Jack Roberts over here, who then might be able to shoot the codex.
Moving on target location.
There we go. If you manage to hit, then good. Good work. Right, it was dodged, but she's dead anyway. That's useful. We have the cleaner, Mr. Jack here. You're going to move over here. And you're going to... Oh, I don't want to use your free reload. Fine, you can move over here, I guess.
Finally.
Just stay out of the way. And then we have Rhino. Rhino, you can do... Okay. So you're flanking him, but it's a 53% chance to hit. I want suppression in that area.
Blasting that target.
So it's harder for him to move. I want you. Well, no, I want you to move. And I want you to shoot. That's good, that's good. His shield's down, he's got one health. And finally, we have Samurai, who's going to use his weapon. Use a sword, like he should. Good work. Excellent, right. And now we've got a shield person left over here, which we can't see. And we've got no one who can overwatch. You're turning into a... Oh, God. Well, someone was going to do that. What determines when they turn into faceless?
Time to mop 'em up.
Good, good, good. You should be able to fire at some point. You're going after my friend here. And you're gonna not attack. That's useful. Disorientation removed. Samurai, get this person. Don't move the camera. I'm using it. Get this person out. And then I want you to move forward again. Rhino, I want you to reload. And I want you to dispense as much ammo as possible into this guy.
Ready to go.
Greg, you can fire at him. That's useful. Lightning hands first. Free reload. I added a free reload to his weapon.
Reloaded.
Good, and that means you can fire with your main gun. You can hit, you can kill. Excellent. He's dead. Very nicely done. This is why we have Greg around. Jack, you need to move to a better position. I am recommending here.
Double time.
Affirmative.
Marina, or Mirina, or whatever you decide to call yourself, you're overwatching here, and... Hang on, what? You get another go? How? You used your... Oh, okay. Killing an enemy at a lower elevation with your sniper rifle does not cost a single... only costs a single... I didn't know that.
Let's move already.
That's probably because I'm ignorant of these things. Right, we need to engage, like, the rest of the alien forces now before all the civilians die. Oh, God. So, 5 civilians are dead, 5 civilians are left. If 3 die, we lose. That's not a good prospect. Move over here, I want safety. Good, right, we've activated these people, they're gonna run at us like... crazies. Oh god, that is actually a lot of them. And he doesn't have any backup. Well, shoot. We could try and, like, persuade them to come this way. That is a possibility. You're going to move around the side so that you've got easier stuff to do. Oh god. I know some of them have grenades. I know they have grenades, so that's going to be annoying. You've got a shield already. Have you already got a shield? Overwatch, please. Hello, Greg. You are now going to participate in the Let's Kill Everything. Oh no, your kill zone's on one turn. Well, you can overwatch anyway. They will never know. Unless the computer loves to cheat. I suggest firing now. That's a good shot, 25% chance to hit and you deal full damage. Can you hit with this grenade? Yes. That'll take care of his... Oh no, because another shield will just come on top. I was just hitting this guy because he's got 2 armor, and so killing the armor is better. There we go. He'll be easier to deal with. And let's see how Samurai dies. This guy moves forward and becomes the target of Greg. Greg misses for stupid reasons.
No, wait.
of course, yeah, they're going to go after the objective, aren't they?
It's turning into a massacre out there, Commander. That camp is getting wiped out.
I'm doing the best I can. You know, if you could let me bring another... Oh, God. This is bad. There's a guy right next to you. It's very bad. Because he's now got an energy shield as well. And Stun Lancer is going to move and you're going to... Disorientate. Oh no, you're on 1 HP as well. We need to evac you now.
Sure.
Right. We're going to need to evac you as quickly as possible. Rhino, you need to get in the fray. And you need
on
to start
way.
Gunning down some aliens. Jack, shoot the berserker like no tomorrow. Good, good, good. His shields. And of course the screen goes shaky, shaky. Like it's dance night. Good, you've taken more damage. And then we have our recruit. Destroy him. Good, right. Berserker's down. Samurai is still here. So he should be able to evac after he fires off a shot. So what we want is we want him to get closer so he can do a better flanking shot, and then we evac him. So if we place the evac point here.
Bring in the evac.
We move him here.
Tired of waiting around.
We shoot this fella. And we evac. There we go, you're not dead. Right. Now my job is, like, significantly harder, but that's life, I suppose. I want you to reload, actually. Free reload, please. Otherwise, you know, it's a waste of a kill zone.
Good to go.
Stop moving the camera, for God's sake. Right. Good, right. Area locked down. We have enemy forces incoming. They won't be able to act against us, but that does mean that's the last of the enemy around, as far as I know. We've got this guy who's going to get shot at, but is he going to die? That's a no. Doing very badly here. You're going to overwatch. Next shield person moves. Greg is back firing at him, missing. Oh god, this is not good. Are we going to waste the entire turn? Stunlancer, what are you doing? Right, we lost our recruit. That's nice. Stunlancer moves out. You miss. What is wrong with you today? Oh god, he's unconscious. Oh god. Right, we've got two people who can actually do anything. That's two snipers. And we've got one guy who can't even shoot.
Let's do this.
You're overwatching.
On overwatch.
Jack. There's a guy who's currently being thinged. So that's 3, 6. So you've got a good-ish chance that if you hit, you kill him. That's kind of the point. Good, he's dead. Right.
Target neutralized.
You're currently being flanked, which is not very good. But you had to fire. Because we don't want that Stun Lancer around. You're going to get shot at by the shield. No, he's going to stay there. You're probably going to stay there. We have the mech, which is going to move in closer. And then he's going to... Oh, okay. Fine, move into range where we can shoot you. And then he's going to get shot right in the face next turn. Stun Lancer comes in. He's probably going to hit him. You're also unconscious. What is wrong? Did I say something mean? Right. We're in a very dire situation. Greg is the only one left in the battlefield. that isn't unconscious or dead. And we've got to kill 4 people. Now, this is going to be an amazing feat if he manages to succeed. Okay, so we can definitely hit one of them. We can definitely hit either of them. I'm going to prioritize the... Oh, God, actually. Well, let's hit the Stun Lancer. Because if the Stun Lancer manages to make Greg unconscious, then this entire thing's over. So we'll focus on killing the Stun Lancer. However, no. We're going to shoot the Stun Lancer with our main weapon to kill him. Right, yeah. That's part one. And part two is Lightning Hands. And then part three... Oh, I didn't do that correctly, did I? No, because, yeah, sniper shots while on a ledge don't only take up... Damn it, I forgot that. And then shoot pistol again. 1 damage, right. Now we see that this very nice person starts shooting at me. Or no, you're just going to keep moving and getting closer. You're going to move in and get closer. All for dying. Mech gets closer. Are you going to grenade my position? No, you're going to suppress. I have 2 words for that. 2 words which I'm not going to say. Right, let's shoot this fella. You've got to hit... You've got to kill him. Good, he's dead. Right, suppression removed. We've got 2 shield bearers left. You can shoot one of them with your pistol. I'm probably going to go with the currently less armored one. Deal 1 piece of damage. And now we have to wait until next turn where they're probably going to move in. I would have sworn that they would... Oh god, he's down there. You just gotta try and get out of sight. Right. There is one down here. Yeah, down here. Probably here, where I can't see him. Or he's moved around. And we've got 1 person here. We can't move, because if we do, we kind of, like, spoil the entire thing. We're going to shoot this guy first, to get rid of the Overwatch. This is amazing. That's death from above, and then we're going to move you over here, because the enemy can't see us, or we can move here, but that might give a chance for the enemy to see us. Enemy moves up. You're going to move over here. You're not in a flanking area. And I'm so sorry, but we are going to kill you. Just give me a second to whittle your health down with my pistol. Really should upgrade the pistol at some point. Right. Can he make it through without getting scathed? No. Yes, he can. He definitely can. That's an amazing feat of everything that you're doing. Can we throw a frag grenade and then lightning hands? Though, I guess there's no point, really. Right, we need to get into a better position to lightning hands, I'm suggesting here. Here I come. Now, what would be a real bummer if this isn't the last guy? 1 damage.
Armor still holding.
And we grenade him.
Get ready for a surprise!
Oh yes, of course, there's a faceless, isn't there? Okay, now you need to one-on-one with a faceless. My god. Greg, you are the hero. Right, you need to move into a better position to combat the faceless. Sadly, none of your people who are currently unconscious can help you. Here we go, here's the faceless. I can't see him, though. Oh, there he is. Oh god, he's close. Right. You have a 10% chance and you'll kill him. I don't like those odds. Now, if we had lightning hands... Yeah, you see. Oh no, 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 wait. We have, if we have an elevation advantage, we can fire using our pistol as well. What the... I had elevation... Oh, yeah. He's a faceless, so he's like two stories tall. You're going to do a swipey swipey. Injuring, which is merely a flesh wound, and now we unload our... Oh god. No, that's a bad idea. We can either get a chance to kill him now. Oh no, no, we won't be able to. Fire with the sniper rifle and see if we kill him. Can't you just hip-fire this thing? Very nice. Now, is there another faceless here?
Menace 1-5, status confirmed. We're not picking up any additional contacts. The AO is clear.
And that is why he's
status
called
confirmed.
The cleaner.
Mission accomplished.
See? Everyone else was out of action. Everyone else was out of action, and then the cleaner comes in, like the cavalry, and clears up the rest of the enemies. Five enemies he single-handedly defeated. That is called heroism. Look, 100% shot. Oh, good. Yeah, that's good. That's really good. Yeah, 100% shot rate. The Cleaner is his name, and that is why. The legend of Greg the Cleaner Knight, Captain Greg the Cleaner Knight, is founded in history now. Sadly, our rookie died, but we managed to get Samurai out before he did. Hopefully we'll have enough people before, you know, another stupid mission comes along, so that we can take out the alien facility that has been bothering me so much. And by bothering, I mean there's one more thing that they need to do and then they kind of win. So we need to do that. We also need to get the mag cannon, because I'm sure my grenadiers aren't very happy that they're using archaic weaponry, especially since this is 20 years in the future and they're using exactly the same weapons as before. Here we go. Sky Ranger, ever vigilant. Guseva is dead. Everyone is gravely wounded. Oh god, how are you gravely wounded? You took 3 damage. Right, you're getting long watch because it's stupidly useful. How are you gravely wounded? You took 3 damage. 3. It is merely a flesh wound. Stop complaining. Right, we've got a Codex Brain as an objective item. Is it? I guess so, because we haven't done that thing yet. And we've got corpses, because, you know, Mr. Tigan over here loves his autopsies.
Hello, Commander.
We're getting thin on manpower, Commander.
No!
We should check with Resistance HQ for new recruits.
Are we thin on manpower? I didn't realize. The only people available are rookies. Right. So, in addition to rookies, it'll take 4. 6 days until we can actually assault the thing. With a full squad. That's not good enough. That is not good enough. New combat tactics. How much is it for squad size 2? 75. Okay. Well, that didn't go as good as I expected, because now we're going to have to wait another bloody month until we can do the alien thing. Abandoned camp. That gives intel. What else do we have? We have an engineer. All this. Oh yes, I was in the middle of something before someone interrupted. Let's go get the intel. And hope that, you know, a UFO doesn't turn up.
Commander, we're being tracked.
What by?
Another UFO!
Oh, damn it. We have no one readily available to deal with it. Right. Let's do this thing.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do.
What's this allowed us to do?
Advent has legions of these mechanized units out there helping to keep the peace. As far as I can tell, they're fully automated and armed to the teeth.
It's only because we can't make reliable robots. Right, Gremlin Mark II and Blue Screen Protocol. And we have Berserker, Muton, Shieldbearer, or Illyrium.
Okay, physically.
Shieldbearer. I'm skipping that because my
constant vigil over my activities is starting to wear thin.
I know. It's going to stay like that. Let's keep going.
Shadow chamber now operational.
Ooh.
Although I'm impressed with the strides we've made in infiltrating the alien psionic network, the depths of their technological advancement continue to leave us one step behind. However, with the enhanced decryption capabilities of this chamber, I'm confident we will find a great deal more information than we had previously hoped.
Fancy.
New objective added.
Examine the recovered black site file.
New objective added.
Examine the codex brain.
We are fully prepared to begin our analysis of the material recovered from the Advent black site, Commander.
Well,
the shadow chamber fully operational. We can use its advanced decryption capabilities to analyze the codex artifact recovered by our forces.
Thank you. Thanks. Thanks. Right. We have a spare engineer available, so let's get this alien machinery dealt with. Because I'm sure we want to clear everything first. Right. We need to build a power relay here, but we don't have enough money. We will in 9 days when we get the clearing alien debris stuff. We're going to start the shadow one of the shadow projects as soon as the shield breaker. No. Shield bearer tech is finished.
These findings will likely prove crucial to our ongoing efforts, Commander. These shield bearers are not all that dissimilar from their various Advent peers. Their armor is perhaps the most distinctive feature differentiating them.
Right, we're going to activate a shadow project. We can either go for the Black Site Vial or the Codex Brain. Well, I believe I want to have a look at the Black Site Vial first, since that's the first thing we got. I think, yeah. There we go. Decryption progresses fast. Very nice. Right, let's go to the bridge and let's continue things. We get an experimental grenade in 3, we get new intel in 3. Acid grenade.
Strategic resource located.
Thank you. Was that an alien? I need to pause the video there when I edit things. Right, we're heading to the black market.
Avenger,
because we have intel.
New course.
And I'm pretty sick of having no one capable of doing anything. I want to be able to assault the black site as soon... Well, not the black site. The alien facility as soon as possible, because I don't want them winning. Right. What do you have? No one useful. Thanks a lot. What else do we have? We have... Advanced repeater, advanced scope, alien crystals, alien allies, blah, blah, blah. I don't care. Can we sell anything that you want? Stunlancer corpses? Sure thing! We'll keep 5, because I'm sure Tigan wants them. Or Valen, once she comes back from the dead. We'll sell you some more corpses as well. I don't know what you want with these corpses, because we've already taken the armor off of them. Target practice, maybe? We'll sell you... Sell you some mutant corpses. There's going to be plenty more where that came from. Viper, we've only got one, and I'm sure Tigan wants that. For means that are not scientific. Here's some faceless stuff so that you can identify them, and yeah, this is kind of all that I'm selling. What do we get? 119. Very nice.
Incoming message for you, Commander. Patching it through to your quarters now.
Oh, it's the end of the month.
The resistance is a daunting task, Commander. But your efforts so far have left many wondering.
Okay.
If we've made the
new
right
facilities
approach,
in 2 weeks.
We will have to do better.
New facility? 2 weeks. We have to assault
Commander,
this thing.
We have the shadow chamber running the numbers. Ooh. These are the tactical projections for our next field operation.
Okay, so there's an enemy unknown. XCOM, enemy no, that was the last game. We've got Vipers, Advanced Officers, Heavy Lancers, Advanced Troopers, Codex, Muton, Shield Bearers. What's the unknown one? I'm having a guess. Well, no, I'm trying to think of what that could be, because I've already played through the game once. But I don't know which one comes next, and I hope it's not the thing I'm thinking of, because those are goddamn tough. Right, we've got a black site vial thing research in a second. Let's have a look at the black market for a second. Do you have... Ooh, we've got a specialist. And some supplies if we want. That's going to require 80 intel. We'll come back in a second. We can get some more people once we head back to the HQ. First of all, let's head to the supply depot. Or the supply drop, rather. I don't know why you just drop them there, and it takes us days to find them. Give us exact coordinates. Oh,
Commander,
shoot.
The aliens continue to make progress on the Avatar project. If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
Oh, God, Commander, we've got 19 days.
We're almost out of time. The Avatar project is entering its final stages. The only way we're going to slow the Elders' progress is by destroying one of their facilities. We have to move fast or everything we've worked towards will be lost.
Okay, well, this countdown is not helping. 19 days. That's going to go by really fast.
Still can't believe it's come to this.
I truly hope those gruesome images are the worst of what we find today.
They're slaughtering us, Doctor. What could be worse?
We're about to find out. I've patched the Shadow Chamber directly into the ship's computer. It's been sifting through the material we've recovered non-stop since our return, cataloging sequences.
Genetic sequences, in near infinite combinations, yet all bearing similar genetic markers. Human markers.
There must be thousands of them.
Tens of thousands, and the procedure is still nowhere near complete.
Which is why we need the ship's computer to find out where they came from. By cross-referencing them with the data we've managed to hack from the Advent network. It's an admission file from one of the gene therapy clinics.
Avatar. Just what exactly is in that vial?
In my worst nightmares, I would never have imagined.
Doctor.
I believe we have found the missing civilians.
That's impossible.
The gene clinics. Millions of people just looking for help.
Medically screened and selected. Suitable candidates taken to that contemptible facility to be processed, refined into the material we now possess.
But why do this?
I could not begin to fathom a guess at this point. There exists no research that would ever warrant this.
It's genocide, Doctor. And these people are walking right into it. We may not know what they're doing with this stuff, but I think I can find out where it's going. Got it. It's a high-security production facility. Standard defensive complement.
Then I strongly suggest we pay them a visit, Commander.
Agreed. The information we gain could prove invaluable towards stopping the aliens' true agenda.
New objective added.
Oh God, we've got another thing to do. Well, that's helpful. What's this? Go to the black site vial coordinates. Okay.
We're ready to move when you are, Commander. I've updated our objectives based on the latest information.
So this thing is made of, like, millions of humans. 1 million people. God. Okay. Culmination of their genetic code. Right, let's do another one. Let's do the Codex Brain. Oh, look. Shen and Tigan? No. Shen and Tigan are both here. Very nice. Okay. Let's see how long I can go.
Commander, we have the coordinates of the Alien Forge facility. I've marked its position on the map.
Thank you.
We'll need to contact the local resistance before we can attempt to move in, though.
Oh, okay. Well, at least it's in Mexico. New Mexico, which is easier to get to. We need these supplies. Thank you. Fly back to the Resistance HQ immediately. Hopefully we don't get attacked by anyone. Because that would be painful. Right. I need another person.
Welcome, Commander.
Right, we've got you as a specialist. We're taking you in. Good, you're awaiting orders. Next, I want intel. Alien debris cleared, that means more supplies. Good, let's build another power relay here. Power relay build.
Construction initiated.
Right, you have been given over. You also have one extra person to use. We're going into overtime here. The aliens are about to win. Engineering. Items. We want the mag cannon, please. Mag cannon. Good. Armor? No. This? No. Yeah, we've run out of supplies again, but that's fine.
All those people. Millions of innocent lives unknowingly walking right into...
I need intel.
Commander, we're making progress piecing this thing back together, but it hasn't been pretty.
Our soldiers completely disabled this unit in the field. What we're hearing is merely a byproduct of electrical impulses. I assure you, it is well past the point of feeling pain.
I'll take your word for it, Doctor.
I'm sending you a new secret now.
These are coordinates. Return coordinates. I think we've got a point of origin. Well, part of one.
Something else. Something underneath.
One more.
The unit is attempting to block further access.
That's not all it's doing. I'm losing the data we've already decrypted.
Almost there. Just one more adjustment.
Forget the data. It's accessing the power core. Overriding my safety. Increasing power levels to Dagon. Sever the connection.
There. Some sort of fail-safe protocol, I imagine. The Codex must have intentionally overloaded the interface to prevent any further theft of information. Still, I believe I was one step ahead.
That's an enormous amount of data.
Yes, and I expect it may take some time to decipher.
Better get started. I don't think we're going to be able to do that again.
I'll proceed with the necessary research and preparation. With your approval, of course, Commander. I'd also suggest we look into those coordinates.
That's if I can reconstruct the data we lost in the transfer. I just hope it was worth it.
New objective added.
Hooray! We've got more things to decrypt.
It looks like we've got our work cut out for us, Commander.
In the field. The Codex appears as an anomalous form, in an almost constant state of flux, seemingly only present in our world for milliseconds at a time. However, it was apparently not immune to the effects of conventional weaponry, having dissipated before leaving behind this object.
Thanks, Tigan. Right, we've got... Oh god, what's in the armory? A few soldiers, yes, we've got... Warden! That's nice. You can hack an A protocol, but now... We get to promote you the way I want. You're a medic. Sorry, but you're a medic. Have haywire protocol. It's useful. Field medic. It's useful. There we go. Very nice. We've got someone who's actually good at doing things. And I believe, 1, 2, 3, yes! We have enough people to do a mission. Finally. You've got research to do, I believe. No, not that kind of research. You're heading to the Shadow Chamber. No, I don't want to assign research. Go away. I'm assigning Shadow Chamber research, which we can't do at the same time. What do we need? Oh. 4 scientists. Well, okay then. I shall do something else.
I am ready to begin on your order, Commander.
Well, you can't. You don't have enough sciencey people. Let's look at the Berserker, shall we?
This fearsome creature, long referred to as a Berserker, is clearly a genetic relation to the other mutant species we have encountered in the field. For reasons yet unknown, this particular variant is unique in that it is altogether consumed by what can only be described as blind rage, a thirst for combat, unlike any other creature we've encountered.
Yes, I assume that's why it's called the Berserker. Thank you. Right. We need one more piece of intel and I'm going to,
We've locked in the coordinates Shen and Tigan pulled from the Codex, Commander. But we'll have to make contact with the local resistance cell before we can move to investigate the site.
New objective added.
Oh god. Okay, so we've got 3 facilities that we can go to slow down the dark event. Shut up! Findings. I don't want you moving. Pause time, will you? Right. We have alien facility. We have this thing, which is known as, what, a forge? Okay. We need to contact New Mexico to be able to do anything with that, though. And we've got this, which is the cutout brain coordinates. However, we can't access it because we need to go via... Oh god, that's going to take ages to get to. Oh no, alternatively... we can go to India, we can go here, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, or 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. That's going to be a lot of intel. Meanwhile, guess where we're going next episode? Hello! It's called the Operation Spider Slap. We're going to assault the alien facility next episode because I really don't like this countdown timer. It's, you know, it's going down. I could just sit here for, like, how long? 14... No, it's not 14 hours. It's just an amount of time. I've got 2 weeks to push back the Avatar project enough so that it goes out of this It's Complete in 2 days thing. Until then, my name has been Zero Jake. End transmission.